I'm Tracy Baxter with today's Record News Watch. The Sullivan County Court trial of Richard Grillo continued today, and the White Lake man is now defending himself. Grillo was accused of being the ringleader in a series of home burglary incidents in the Bethel-Mongop Valley area. He rejected a plea deal and instead will be serving as his own attorney for the rest of the trial. Grillo has prior felony convictions involving area home burglaries. Now that he's rejected the deals, he could get up to life in prison if he's convicted of the most recent burglary, grand larceny, and criminal possession of stolen property charges. Prosecutors say DNA evidence links Grillo to stolen property. A handful of labor representatives gathered outside the Goshen office of Republican Congresswoman Nan Hayworth Thursday to call on Congress to approve a payroll tax cut and to extend unemployment benefits for jobless residents.
We need Congresswoman Hayworth to make sure that unemployment insurance doesn't expire at the end of the month. There are so many people in the state and in the country that need that help. While finding a job is very, very difficult, we're asking her to stand up for working people. I think in the country that people all over the country are now starting to see that workers need to be helped, that they count, and that as Americans we ought to be doing our best for everybody concerned, especially during this holiday season.
Labor officials don't want a provision supporting an oil pipeline from Canada to Texas included in the unemployment benefits legislation, saying that would jeopardize the bill. Hayworth has said any legislation that's considered needs to minimize the burden on future generations of taxpayers. Despite the struggling economy, a consulting firm has confirmed what the folks in Bethel already know. The six-year-old Bethel Woods Center for the Arts and the performers it draws is providing a major boost to the surrounding area. According to the report, Bethel Woods has created more than 450 jobs and generated more than $8 million worth of salaries. Look for reporter Steve Israel's story on the impact of Bethel Woods in the Sunday edition of the Times-Herald Record. It's been happening more and more during these tough economic times. Local residents who are employed and self-sufficient now facing times of financial hardship. And for the past 25 years, the Times-Herald Record's People for People Fund has been there to answer the call.
How behind is your rent?
Volunteers screen application requests for one-time assistance to help those who found themselves facing a temporary emergency.
The fund is now really working with many people who have been caught up in the whole economic crisis. People who had excellent jobs, good paying jobs, where they thought they could manage to afford really their own lifestyle, and then due to a change in the economy, all of a sudden either lost a job or both jobs in a family, and now cannot pay the normal everyday living bills, are trying to cut back as rapidly as they can. But our goal, hopefully, is to give these people a little bit of boost.
Since 1985, thousands of people in Orange, Sullivan, Ulster, and Pike counties have gotten help through People for People. No money is paid to the applicant directly. The one-time funding does go directly to the vendor. Now, to find out more about contributing to the fund or volunteering, or to see if you can qualify for assistance, contact People for People at 845-343-1663 or go to www.recordspeoplefund.org.
For the fields we go, laughing all the way.
What do you get when you combine more than 3,000 lights, over a mile of extension cords, Christmas music, and a computer? You get something that's once again entertaining those who stop by the Canaltown Emporium store in Wurtsboro this holiday season. For the past few years, the store and Wurtsboro resident Michael Russa have teamed up to create Dance of the Lights, a show that uses computer technology to synchronize a sound and light show that gets visitors into the spirit of the season.
It's hundreds of hours of work for a 10-minute show, but each year we get a little better at it, so we're kind of shaving the time down a little bit. But at the same time, we look at this year's show and we're also thinking about what we're going to be doing for next year. Yeah, we always want to change up a little bit. We add at least one new song a year. We're going to try for maybe two next year. We try to put a few different effects. Like last year we added Rudolph, this year we added Santa Claus. So we try to throw in different effects every year too. There's times in October we're pulling our hair out because we're wondering if it's going to work out. But when it all comes together, we're real happy with it and we're happy we did it.
A number of people have said it's now a family tradition to come and see it because it's not always the same. We rotate songs and we put in new songs. So they come every year to see the light show and hopefully get them in the holiday mood.
You can check out Dance of the Lights each evening beginning at 7 p.m. outside Canal Town in Wurtsboro through Christmas Eve. And it wasn't your normal West Point change of command ceremony. Three of Army's mascot mules, who spent years roaming the sidelines at Army football games, were officially relieved of their duties last night. The departing mules will be spending their retirement years at farms in Michigan and Pennsylvania. They've been replaced by two larger mules named Ranger 3 and Striker, who trained for their mascot duties at Fort Bragg, North Carolina. Ranger 3 and Striker won't have any time to rest on their laurels. Tomorrow they'll be called on to help drum up support for Army when they battle Navy. Sunshine will dominate our weather this weekend, but that does not mean it'll be warm. Saturday will be mostly sunny and chilly, with the highs only around 40 degrees. Sunday will be a bit warmer, with temperatures reaching the mid-40s under a mostly sunny sky. You'll get the news and features you've come to depend on in the weekend editions of the Times Herald Record. And when news breaks, you will find it here at Record Online. For Record News Watch, I'm Tracy Baxter.